Good morning, good evening, or good night, whenever you might be watching this. Our baccalaureate ceremony, is the one of class of 2020, gives the senior class an opportunity to reflect on the past 12 years of education and look forward to the future. Class, as you reflect over your education, think about the legacy you have left and those that follow. You have continued the tradition of community service, and you have distinguished yourselves in the arts, athletics, and academics. Consequently, I believe that I speak for the faculty and staff here at FC when I say that you are well prepared for what lies ahead. Before we start, I'd like to offer special thanks to several people, Mrs. Hampton and a portion of the choir for sharing their talents, as well as Mr. Clooney for his speech. And of course, this entire program is a lot different than what we've done in the past. We typically would have an entire choir singing. We would have students walk into the auditorium together. But we're at a different format and we're doing the best we can. And we think that you will have a fantastic program ahead. Graduation is one of the few rites of passages that we still have in our society, but it is one to be celebrated for years of hard work and much earned success. Tonight, I'll leave you with this before I yield the stage to other performers. There are many reasons people become successful. It could be due to talent, determination, maybe even luck. But there's one reason that all of you share, one common reason that brings you here into the ceremonies in the coming weeks. And to be fair, I don't really deviate this message in baccalaureate from year to year because I think it rings true and it sets a good tone for the remainder of the year for the seniors. It'll come across as sentimental, but then again, all of these upcoming events are sentimental occasions. You are all here because someone loved you. Someone took the time to give you attention and nurture you in your most formative and vulnerable years. Because of that, please take some time over the next few weeks to show your appreciation to those who have made a difference in your journey, whether it be a parent, family, friend, or even a classmate. I also encourage you to spend some time, virtual or otherwise, with some of those not so close friends, those just on the periphery of your life. Over the years, you'll likely keep in touch with close friends, but lose contact with others that you might see daily, but not be that close to. Take it from this old man. You really miss those people. So with that said, I want to thank every parent, guardian, grandparent, relative, and friend here tonight for the years of love and support you have given to these graduates. And now I'd like to introduce Ms. Felicia Mao, the secretary of the senior class, who will open the ceremony this evening, as well as introduce our guest speaker.
It is my pleasure to welcome everyone to our virtual gathering in celebration of Floyd Central's senior class of 2020. There are so many people to thank on behalf of this class who deserve to be recognized. Thank you to the choir and Mrs. Hampton for gifting us with such beautiful songs. The class of 2020 is grateful for the music that brightens this event in a celebratory mood. Thank you to the teachers, staff members, and administrators for their hard work and dedication in equipping the students with priceless education, comfort, and structure. The class of 2020 has flourished. Thank you to parents and those who always support the members of the class. The class of 2020 grows with the sunshine of their unconditional love and encouragement. We are gathered here today from homes scattered across town, connected by a similar bond. The class of 2020. These are particularly challenging times. Still, the members of this community have shown remarkable and admirable resilience. Yes, the coronavirus has changed our way of life. You have probably heard this before. This is not how senior year was supposed to end. It's very true. Each of you are ever deserving to enjoy your senior year. However, new enjoyments take the place of stolen enjoyments. In quiet moments, I have had time to reflect on what this situation highlights. These moments really show our true colors, white, green, and gold. Technology still connects us to each other with a smile and comforting words. So many have used technology or other means to ease the pain of others and express our love for Floyd Central. The ability to create positivity in difficult situations demonstrates unity, a crucial component of Floyd Central. What makes this class special is incapable of being put into words. We are a diverse group. Each member is a precious jewel that glitters on our shared crown. Neither your efforts nor your impressive accomplishment have gone unnoticed. What we share is our connection to Floyd Central. you did not have a chance to give a proper goodbye. To find closure, some of you drew chalk images on your parking space. You probably miss your classmates, teachers, or even the hallways. Leaving Floyd Central, know you can trace your steps to the same place you have gone to for 4 years, one that has been with you in the bad and good, mistakes and lessons learned, personal or academic. Your high school years may be closing, but a new stage is opening. We are now left with memories. Choose to keep what you cherish, whether that be contact with teachers and classmates. Find satisfaction in your high school closure. The past becomes the present. This means your experiences at Floyd Central will somehow shape where you are going next. Live life with a young heart, but let your mind age with wisdom. Whether you will enter into the workforce or college, Floyd Central is forever a part of your story. I wish you all the very best. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2020. Now I would like to introduce our next guest speaker. She is a beloved psychology teacher at Floyd Central. Please welcome Mr. Chad Clooney.
Floyd Central, class of 2020, congratulations. Let me first say it's an honor to be a part of this celebration today. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Chad Clooney. I teach psychology at Floyd Central. Many months ago, Dr. Willman came to me and asked me if I'd be interested in saying a few words during the ceremony. And at the time I was thinking, why me? And I'm guessing some of you right now are thinking the same thing. Why Mr. Clooney? But that being said, I'm going to try to say a few brief words today about what I've learned over my 75 years of life. I know I look pretty good for a 75-year-old. I only look like I'm 50. I appreciate that. But I want to talk a little bit today about the power of the one. And this is a little bit of something that relates to the world of psychology and studies in psychology, but relates to you as well. I by no means have all the answers, and I'm not here to tell you what you should or shouldn't do, because you are now an adult and you will make those decisions for yourself. You'll make some great decisions. You'll probably make some wrong decisions. But in the end, I'm confident that you're going to accomplish amazing things in life. In the world of psychology, there are many, many famous studies. One of the famous studies that comes from the field of social psychology comes from a guy by the name of Stanley Milgram, who studied the willingness of people to obey authority figures, even when they probably shouldn't. Another, maybe the most famous study ever done in psychology was a guy named Philip Zimbardo, who did something called the Stanford Prison Experiment in the early 1970s. And he talked about the power of the situation. In both cases, for those of you who haven't heard about them, they really look at the darker side of humanity and what people do sometimes in situations and what people are willing to do because someone tells them to do so. What I think is unfortunate, though, is in the world of psychology, we sometimes look only at the dark side of humanity. And today, I'm going to choose to look at the bright side. I'm going to talk a little bit about the power of the one, because I believe, I truly believe, each and every one of you can be the one. Now, I'm not talking about the one who accomplishes everything. I'm not talking about the one who does not make a mistake. That doesn't exist, right? We all are going to make mistakes along the way. We're all going to sometimes choose the wrong path to realize that we need to correct a wrong. But that being said, we all have the ability to be the one. So what is that one? What does that look like? And if you look back at the history, you look at situations where horrible things were happening, whether it was in the world or in the United States itself. Yet you see people in those moments who do incredible things for other people. You see people who have the conviction, people who have the passion and the compassion to choose to put others before themselves. You know, whether it's Abraham Lincoln during the Civil War, whether it's Gandhi, whether it's Martin Luther King Jr. during the Civil Rights Movement, whether it's FDR during the Great Depression and World War II, right? But it's not just famous people. It's everyday people. You know, I was born in a very simple background. I'm from DePaul, Indiana, little bitty town in Harrison County. If you were to drive down 64 and blink your eye, you'd miss it right before you even got through it. But I had many, many people in my life that were the one. And I truly believe that's the difference. That's the difference for a lot of us. Having someone in your life that is the one. So what does that mean? Being the one means having faith. Having faith in who you are. Having faith in humanity. It also means having compassion for others and putting others' needs in front of you. You know, another famous psychologist by the name of Abraham Maslow, maybe some of you have heard of him, came up with this notion of a hierarchy of needs. And at the top of that, he talked about the top of the hierarchy was this notion of being self-actualized, right? And what he meant by that was being all you could be, reaching your full unique potential. And, you know, he didn't feel like you could automatically become self-actualized. He felt like lots of other needs need to be met, whether it was basic needs like food and water, love and belonging needs, people providing you self-esteem and confidence. But he truly felt that each and every one of us had the ability to become what he would call self-actualized, reaching our full unique potential. But I don't know if that's possible if we don't have each other, right? Being the one means choosing to be the person that puts other people in front of you, choosing to be the person that makes a difference in someone else's life, right? It doesn't mean that you have to be someone famous. It doesn't mean that you have to be someone that history will talk about. Every day right now, you look around in our society, you know, things are crazy right now. Things are very different than what most of us thought they would be 6 months ago. But yet, you see people each and every day in the world around us being that one, right? You see doctors and nurses, essential workers putting their life in danger, oftentimes for people that they may not know and may never meet again. But they're choosing to be the one, right? Many of you are going to go out and you're going to go on with your life. Some of you are going to go on to college. Some of you are going to go directly into the workforce, right? You're going to choose lots of different career paths. You're going to choose lots of different life paths. But yet, I challenge you to be the one, right? I don't know what that'll look like for you. I don't know who that'll look like for you. I don't know who that'll be. What I do know is that each and every one of us has the ability to do so. Doesn't matter what your career is. It doesn't matter what your socioeconomic status is. It doesn't matter what your background is, right? It's really about putting other people ahead of yourself sometimes. And it's really about having compassion for others. And like I said, we all make mistakes, right? We all are going to choose the wrong decision sometimes. But what I'm hoping is that you realize that even though none of us are perfect people, and none of us may have all the right decisions or all the right answers, we all have the ability to make a difference in someone's life, right? You don't have to be a perfect person to make someone's life better, right? And each and every one of us, if we're willing to go out and we're willing to make the difference in someone else's life, then you think about the potential for a better world. And I have faith in you. I have faith in you guys. I have faith in humanity. I truly do believe in moments where things are difficult and life is not easy, people rise to the occasion, right? People go out of their way to make other people's lives better. And that's what I ask you to consider, you know, as you move forward in your life. I wish you the best of luck. I know many of you are going to go on to do amazing, amazing things. I see this in the classroom setting, right? I look around the class and I see students, I think, man, they are so much more determined than I was at their age. They're highly intelligent, they're motivated, they're compassionate towards other people. And that's why I know, even when things are chaotic and even when maybe we're not sure how all this is going to turn out and what the new normal will look like, I know with you guys being the next generation, we're in good hands, because each and every one of you has the potential to be the one for someone else, to make a difference in their life. So, you know, I want you to think about that. When you wake up every morning, think about how blessed you are, right? How you have the opportunity to change other people's lives for the better, to treat people sincerely and genuinely and kindly. And no, that's not always easy. And yeah, we're going to disagree with people sometimes, and that's okay, right? But think about how you can make a difference in their life. I've had lots and lots of people, from grandparents to parents to family, friends, who have made a difference in my life. And I suspect many of you, right, would not be the person you are today if you didn't have that one in your life. Those people who have chosen to put your needs above theirs. So, you know, maybe you think those people, but as important, go out and make a difference. Go out and show people compassion and kindness. And if we all do that, the world's going to be a better place tomorrow than it is today. I thank you for this time. Thank you for being willing to listen. And we're very proud of you at Floyd Central. We know that you guys are the future leaders and you're going to make a difference in this world. So go out and accomplish amazing things. Create the things that you wish existed.
Hello, my name is Nick Landrum, and I will be performing Homeward Bound by Jay Althaus and Marta Keene.
In the quiet, misty morning, when the moon has gone to bed, when the sparrows stop their singing, and the sky is clear and red, when the summer ceased its gleaming, when the corn is past its prime, when adventure's lost its meaning, I'll be homeward bound in time. Bind me not to the pasture, chain me not to the plow, set me free to find my calling, and I'll return to you somehow. If you find it's me you're missing, if you're hoping I'll return, to your thoughts I'll soon be listening. In the road I'll stop and turn, then the wind will set me racing, as my journey nears its end, and the path I'll when I'm homeward bound again. Bind me not to the pasture, chain me not to the plow, set me free to find my calling, and I'll return to you somehow. In the quiet, misty
Thank you, Mr. Clooney, for your inspiring thoughts. Also, thanks to Nick Landrum and our award-winning choir, along with their amazing director, Mrs. Hampton. This spring has been a challenge. We will certainly never forget our final semester at Floyd Central. Think about the stories we'll be able to tell our grandkids. Yes, the world came to a halt, but we should be proud. We were able to rise to the occasion, and that is because of the tools and experiences that Floyd Central has given us. For 4 years, FC has been our home. A piece of that home will always be in our hearts. We will carry it with us wherever we go as we set out to change the world. It is my hope that this pandemic is the toughest battle we ever face, and these are the worst disappointments we ever endure. However, this experience has given us a new perspective. So regardless of what life sends us, I'm confident we will succeed.